West Coast had to play a game of footy amidst all this last night, and they played very, very well. In fact, they're emerging as a real contender in the competition. And you look at the results from last night, a 54-point win, 16-18, 114 to 9-6-60. A 54-point win. Darling kicked five. He's come back roaring. I thought he'd take some time. He's in sensational form. Gaff continues to become a star, and they've been pretty pleased with where they sit at the moment.
Look at the scoring shots, 35 shots of goal, Scotty. They were in awesome force, sliced Melbourne up.
Oh, I reckon they were only going in second gear as well. I mean, it was just a comprehensive, complete performance. Trittis, yeah, just Brownlow medalist. You expect the flashy things, but let's have a look at his tackling pressure. He comes off here bloodied again. That had happened most games for him. But his tackling pressure, 10 tackles to half-time, that's outstanding work.
And you've got to consider, Melbourne had a home ground advantage. They've been in good form. They're going to disrupt your ball movement. They're going to pick off players like Matthew Prittis, Bernie Vince tagged him. And West Coast absorbed all that and sliced up Melbourne convincingly.
The way they're kicking the ball, Scott, and their entries inside 50, is a bit Hawthorn-like, you feel?
I thought I was watching Hawthorn. So what Adam Simpson has brought to this side, look at these bullets going inside 50. They are, you can't defend that. That's low, quick. A defender has no opportunity to get a hand in or cut it off. Again, Sheed here turns on his left. Again, another one. Look at the low penetrating flight on these kicks coming in. Unbelievable ball use. Can't defend it.
Jack Darling having a ripping return to AFL football. He's come back beastly, hasn't he?
He is awesome. I mean, he is becoming the player we all thought he would have as a junior. Look at that. He didn't look like missing with his set shots. And how he slid out to pick 20 has got me gobsmacked. But he just looked very, very special last night.
He could be their most important player coming into finals, Hutchie. They need a bit of mongrel. And I think he's the one player that can really provide that.
Look at this. The combination of the two of them stacks up better than anyone in the competition right now. 3.5, 3.6. Yeah, towers over Cameron McCarthy and Franklin Tippett, where the money goes. Almost $2 million tied up there. Is this the best combination in the comp right now?
Well, arguably, because they're both great players. They've spent some time together. They've spent time connecting with the midfield. But you know what I like about both of them, Scotty? If they don't win the ball in the air, they get it at ground level and they run down the opposition.
Yeah, when you look through that list, they're probably the most mobile pairing of all of them. So they're defensively playing well.